How do we know God?
We know God in part by a revelation of himself in the world which he has created, but he gives us the saving knowledge of himself only in the Bible, which the Holy Spirit enables us to understand.
What is the Bible?
The Bible is the word of God, a collection of books written by men who are guided by God to teach us about himself and his will.
What is man?
Man is God's creation, made in the image of his creator, but through his disobedience, he became and continues to be the servant of sin.
What is sin?
Sin is that evil nature within us which leads us to disobey God or fall short of what he would have us be and do.
Who is Jesus Christ?
Jesus Christ is God's eternal and only begotten Son, who having humbled himself to become man, is both God and man.
Why is Jesus called? How do we receive Jesus Christ as our Savior?
We receive Jesus Christ as our Savior by repentance and faith.
What is it to repent?
To repent is to be truly sorry for sin and to turn from it to God for forgiveness with sincere purpose to do God's will.
What is the duty and privilege of those who believe in Jesus Christ?
The duty and privilege of those who believe in Jesus Christ is to confess him before men, to live in fellowship with God, to come into full communion of the church, and to do good to all men.
What is the purpose of the church?
The purpose of the church is to glorify God, to bear witness to Jesus Christ, and to be the channel of God's saving power, so that his kingdom may come and his will be done in all the earth.
What is the kingdom of God?
The kingdom of God is the rule of God in the hearts of all his people, so that in love to him and to their fellow men, they may live in righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit.
What are the means of grace?
The means of grace are the helps that God has given us for living the Christian life, especially the Bible, the sacraments, prayer, and the fellowship of believers.
What is a sacrament?
A sacrament is an outward act with an inward meaning, given by Christ to his church, whereby the Holy Spirit sets forth the love of God and applies it to our lives.
How many sacraments are there?
There are two sacraments, baptism and the Lord's Supper.
What summary did Jesus Christ give of the law and the prophets?
The summary which Jesus Christ gave of the law and the prophets is, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto you, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. These two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
And what is God's ultimate victory?
God's ultimate victory is his final triumph through Christ over all his enemies, so that the kingdoms of this world will become the kingdom of our God and of his Christ.
Amen to that. That was good, right?
Spirit will send down as Jesus ascended into heaven. The Holy Spirit helps us discern what is
accomplished. Dearly beloved, we are now to receive, to the confirmation of their baptism vows and to the Lord's Supper, Lauren Bodner and Joshua Peters. They have received instruction in the teaching of the church. They've been examined and admitted to full communion with the church by the session, and they are ready to confess publicly their faith into which they were baptized. In your baptism, you receive the sign and seal of your union with Christ and were solemnly engaged to be the Lord's. God in his goodness has brought you to years of responsibility, and now you desire to confess it before us. Jesus said, "Whoever shall confess me before others, that person will I also confess in front of my heavenly Father." I ask you these three questions required by the Constitution of the Presbyterian Church. Do you confess your faith in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord? And do you promise with the aid of the Holy Spirit to be Christ's faithful disciple to your life's end? If so, you'll answer, "I do."
I do.
Do you confirm the vows taken for you in baptism, and with a humble and contrite heart, put your whole trust in the mercy of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord? If so, you'll answer, "I do." Do you promise to make diligent use of the means of grace, to share faithfully in the worship and service of the church, to give of your substance as the Lord may prosper you, and to give your whole heart to the service of Christ in his kingdom throughout the world? You'll answer, "I do." Thank you. All stand for prayer. Almighty and eternal God, strengthen these your servants, Joshua and Lauren, we pray, with the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. Increase in them the manifold gifts of grace, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. Keep them in your mercy, now and forever. And Lauren Bodner, we pray this over you. Defend, O Lord, this your servant with your heavenly grace, that she may continue to be yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until she comes to your everlasting kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Joshua Peters, we pray this over you. Defend, O Lord, this your servant with your heavenly grace, that Joshua may continue to be yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes into your everlasting kingdom. Amen. You are now confirmed as members of Christ's church, and we all put the blessing upon you, that the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and be with you.